Okay, Proverbs chapter 4. Proverbs chapter 4. It didn't take me long. God is with me. The Spirit is here.
Yes, sir.
The Holy Ghost is here.
Amen.
Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20. My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ear to my saying. Let them not depart from thy eyes. Keep them in the midst of thy heart. For they are life unto those that find them, and health unto their flesh. Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Okay, useful thought. Take this home with you now. Still become what you believe. Still become what you believe.
Right?
Life is so full, you may see it. Life is full of choices and decisions. Every day we experience seeing erotic changes in the world system. But we as believers can still become what we believe. We find out that we're living in a time, even the behavior of the world and the way the world is going is pointing to the coming of Christ.
Amen.
And the way the world is going, the behavior of leadership, I ain't calling no name. Behavior of people who supposed to be in leadership position. Not just talking about our president, but as many all over the world.
Amen. Amen.
They try to take from man, causing people, they get so in part that they get very discouraged and upset. They want to fight. We live in a hostile society. And we just heard about the governor was about to be kidnapped in one of our cities. But the enemy is like a roaring lion seeking who he may devour. He doesn't care who he take out. But I am so happy in this season that he said, no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. Every tongue that rises against thee in judgment shall be condemned. We as believers don't have to worry, because we still are still standing on the word of God. There is a God-given choice to every man, to every woman. I believe Deuteronomy 13:19 said, today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and curses. Now I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice you make. Oh, that you would choose life, that you and your descendants might live. And I want to say to every believer that is here today, those who love the Lord and serve him, choose life. We may be in a season where death is sweeping the earth, but choose life. This thing the enemy put on the earth, but we as believers can cope with it. We still believe that God can do anything but fail. Let the church say amen. When we choose to believe in the Lord, he brings us salvation.
Amen.
He brings us healing.
Amen.
He brings us deliverance.
Yeah.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
And even in time of circumstances, we don't even have to change.
Yeah.
The fact is that we still believe what God said.
Yeah.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
We think, we change. We change in the physical nature, but in the mind. The Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. The mind, we take our thinking, we think clearly from our mind. And I want to say to every believer, to everybody here, don't let nothing toxic get in your mind. Don't let nothing, let the enemy sow something in your mind that's going to become toxic to you. That messes with your health. That messes with how you're thinking. You pray every day, say, Lord, every day when you get up, say, Lord, give me clarity. Give me what I need to make it through the day. You don't need to go through the day worrying. You don't need to go through a day disappointment. Encourage yourself. Pick yourself up. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
All right. Another thing is our thought life is so important. Everybody say our thought life. It controls our emotions. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Now let's look at Proverbs 4. Follow me as you please. I'm going somewhere. And it says, this, my son, attend to my words. Words, not word, words. Incline thy ear unto my saying. In other words, he said, my son, pay attention to my words. Listen closely to what he says. And he was talking about the word of God. Solomon speaking to his son concerning the word of God. There are four things that happen when we receive the word of God into our spirit. And let me share it with you. Four things that happen. We hear the word. How can we hear without a preacher? How can he preach except he be sent? The next thing that when you hear the word, you receive it.
Amen.
Into your heart. Amen. You receive it into your heart. And by faith, you let faith work. You mix the word with faith.
Amen.
And when you receive it, the next thing that happens is you put the word in action. Hallelujah. Everybody say, put the word in action. It's one thing to receive the word, but will you work the word? You have to work the word. Okay, I'm going somewhere. And it says, another thing what happens when we put the word in action, the next thing that it brings forth fruit. Hallelujah. You exemplify the fruit of the Spirit. Let the church say amen. All right, he said, my son, be attentive. Don't let nothing distract you when you get in the atmosphere and listening to the word of God. Come ready to eat the word of God. Come ready to receive that word. So when you go out next week, you can go out and tackle the enemy. Knock him out. Let the church say amen. Hear the word. Hear the word. The word brings healing. The word brings deliverance. Then it says, let them not depart from thy eyes. Keep them in the midst of thy heart. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, say, you got overcoming victory. Wave at them. Say, you got overcoming victory when you have the word of God. Amen. Solomon said, don't let them out of your sight. In other words, don't let the word escape you. Because you still have become what you believe. Don't let it out of your sight. It's just like many of you mothers, when you had a child and they're very small, you could not let that child out of your sight because the child could not think for itself. But when we have the word of God, amen, we ought to keep the word in sight. Because when we get in a situation, we got to know how to use the word. And we cannot use the word of God unless it comes into our heart. We have to have the mind of Christ for the word of God to take root. Can I get a witness?
We got to keep it in our spirit. We need the word of God to hold us. Can I get a witness? When I look at Deacon Wilkie and Sister Sean, what kept them going, along with Sister Rhonda and family, those that lost loved ones, what kept you going was the word of God. The word picked you up when you was at your lowest point. Is anybody here have been in a low point in your life where you needed to catch another hold? But I thank God when you have the word of God, you can reflect what he did then, he'll still do it now. When you reflect the word of God, it takes you through what the enemy set for a trap. The word of God will pull you through. Can I get a witness? One thing about the word, the enemy hates the word. He don't like for you to use the word. He took Jesus after he and fasted 40 days and 40 nights. The tempter came to him and said, if you be the Son of God, turn these stones into bread. But I heard the enemy was just making chatter. You see, the enemy makes chatter, and you attend to his chatter. He'll put things in your mind. He'll put things in your ear. But Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Keep the word when things get rough, when things get tough, you don't understand and don't have no answers. The word is like a satellite. When you cook up to the satellite, you can get a message. You can get communication. When you got the word in your heart, you can communicate with God above. They say, keep the word, for they are life unto those that find them. They are help to all the flesh. In other words, you'll find healing in the word. You'll find healing, emotional healing. Can I get a witness? We're living in a season. Many people have anxieties, and those anxieties is driving them to think in the flesh. The flesh is our own. A flesh, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and power. But when you have on the whole armor, you have the armor which is the breastplate of righteousness, loins girded about with the truth. Can I get a witness? The shield of faith. And any time we need healing, it will be there to heal the whole body. Somebody need wholeness in this season. Somebody need God to fix some things. Somebody need God to work out some things. Somebody need God for next week. You got some things coming up. You don't know how you're gonna do it, how you're gonna make it. But I heard God say, still become what you believe. Still stand on the word. Still take the word
face value. I'm reminded of Jesus while the disciples was fishing all night. They tall and caught nothing, but I heard Jesus say, lunge out into the deep, catch your net for a drop. Somebody, God said, lunge out, cause I'm bringing wholeness. Keep thy heart with all diligence. I heard the word say, keep your heart. Stand guard. Can I get a witness? Let your heart be guarded with the word of God. Let the heart be guarded with the spirit of God. For out of it flows the spring of life. If you want to live, you got to guard your heart. Don't let fear get in your heart. Don't let frustration get in your heart. Don't let malice, envy get in your heart. Keep your heart clean. I heard the psalmist says, create in me a clean heart, renew in me the right spirit. Cast me not away from thy presence. Don't take your Holy Ghost away from me. Some things you can lose, but I know there's one thing you cannot lose. It's the Holy Ghost power in your life. We need the power. We need the power to have victory. We need the power to take us through every storm. I know somebody is here right now. You're going through a storm, but God says, he's saying right now, rest in the Lord, wait patiently. I'm coming through for you on time. The storm, it looks like it's tossing you to and fro. You don't know if you're going or coming, but I thank God. Look to the hill from whence cometh your help. All of your help come from the Lord. Oh, church, do you know where your help come from? He woke you up early this morning in the midst of a tornado. And swept the house away. But I thank God, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God. Somebody here, you ought to be happy you're in the shadow. Because 2,000 is 2,000, and 10,000 people have lost their lives. But I heard God told me to tell the church, you ain't going nowhere until God get ready. I'm confident he which have done a good work in you will perform it until the day of the Lord. If you hold on a little while longer, Job said, Lord. Job trusts. He said, though you slay me, yet I'll trust you. Though this thing is sweeping through the nation, I'll still trust you. Though the protesters and the white supremacists, God said, I'll protect you. I'll be there when you think I'm not there. I'll be there when the trouble comes. I'll be there when the wind blows. I'll be there when you can't see your way. But not God. Oh yeah, yeah. He gonna work it out. He gonna supply your need. He can take nothing and make something. Something is coming out of nothing in your life. Just stand after you've done all the stand.
R-O-U-G-H.